Item number, SCP-137. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-137 is to be kept in a locked room with a hairbrush and posters depicting a country meadow to keep it placid and tractable. SCP-137 is to be fed 3 meals a day. Under no circumstances are any toys allowed to come within 500 meters of SCP-137. Description: SCP-137 is an entity with the ability to possess a toy, gaining the physical properties, size, and shape of whatever it represents. For example, a teddy bear will become an actual bear and behave accordingly. SCP-137 cannot possess any miscellaneous object, only toys. The observed range of SCP-137's possessive effect is 250 meters, but until further testing has been accomplished, SCP-137 is assumed to have a maximum range of 500 meters from its position. SCP-137 was first brought to Foundation attention after a series of bizarre deaths and incidents involving children. The deaths were determined to be too random to be a serial killer, and Foundation agents were sent in to investigate. It was located after an interview with a young girl suffering from post-traumatic stress disorder after a naked man had appeared in her bedroom. It was encountered in the same neighborhood, in the form of a gorilla. SCP-137 was then tracked and finally captured when it possessed a stuffed pony doll and was chased into the nearby wilderness. SCP-137 was tranquilized and extracted to Site-19 by helicopter. Testing has shown that SCP-137 takes on the characteristics of the toy it possesses, but only as a child might perceive it. A toy soldier becomes a violent, well-armed man. A toy gun fires bullets. A toy lion attacks and kills humans. However, it lacks true intelligence. It shows no sign of long-term memory, nor any capacity for learning or abstract thinking. It is currently inhabiting a princess doll. Addendum, Interview 137-1. Interviewed, SCP-137. Interviewer, Dr. Foreword. Interview took place to determine what SCP-137 is, and why and how it possesses toys. Begin log. Doctor, good day. SCP-137. Hello, I'm Princess Blossom. Are you my prince? Doctor, no. Now, can you please tell me what you are? SCP-137. I am a princess. I am the prettiest princess in the whole world. Doctor, where did you come from? SCP-137. I live in a castle. Are you my prince? Further questioning yielded similar results. End log. Experiment log 137. Date: undisclosed. Test material: a toy jet plane. Results: the toy was replaced by a full-sized F-16, which attempted to take off inside the testing facility, causing a great deal of damage. The debris quickly turned back to plastic, and SCP-137's current form reanimated. Notes: in the future, please avoid testing materials that come equipped with jet engines and missiles. This was an expensive test. Date: undisclosed. Test material: a race car. Results: the toy was replaced by a full-sized Ferrari that attempted to race around the testing facility, ultimately crashing into the wall at high speed. Again, the debris turned back to plastic, and SCP-137's current form was reanimated. Notes: vehicle tests now require permission from Director. Date: undisclosed. Test material: an alligator keychain fob attached to Agent Sorensen's keys. Results: a 6-meter-long saltwater crocodile in a hallway. 14 dead. Notes: all agents must now be searched for toys or toy-like items before entering site. Date: undisclosed. Test material: American soldier action figure. Results: the toy was replaced by an adult male human in a soldier's fatigues, carrying a large rifle, which managed to kill 5 personnel before being terminated. Notes: let's try something less violent next time. Date: undisclosed. Test material: an Officer Jones beat cop action figure. Results: an adult male in a policeman's uniform. It kept asking where the perps had gone to, and insisting that researchers not take recreational pharmaceuticals. After interrogation attempts, it announced that the researchers were criminals, shot two, and handcuffed a third before being terminated. Date: undisclosed. Test material: a stuffed panda. Results: a very large panda. It is to be noted that, despite their cute appearance and herbivorous lifestyle, pandas are still bears. It proceeded to hug one of the researchers, breaking three ribs before it was terminated. Date: undisclosed. Test material: a box of plastic construction bricks. Results: a terracotta brick appeared inside the box. It vanished, replaced by a brick of a different material. This went on for several hours before the items were destroyed, and the anomaly reanimated its current host. Date: undisclosed. Test material: a yo-yo. Results: the yo-yo did not change form. However, it became autonomous, moving on its own and performing a variety of tricks, even when removed from the finger of a researcher and placed on a hook in the wall. Date: undisclosed. Test material: a Dr. Selenium action figure, noted on the packaging to be the smartest man on Earth. Results: an adult male in a lab coat. It made repeated references to its astounding intellect. However, when questioned on any scientific or mathematical knowledge, it would not answer directly, only saying that it was the smartest man on Earth. Testing ended after several hours of fruitless questioning. Date: undisclosed. Test material: a winged unicorn toy, based on a popular children's television show. Results: a small, disproportionately figured purple equine. Junior researcher asked SCP-137 questions about its adopted character and about its magical capabilities, but was answered only with cheerful non sequitur statements. This included asking about said junior researcher's friends, declaring that friendship is the greatest magic, and requesting he fly to the castle with her, despite said junior researcher's lack of wings and SCP-137's lack of a castle. Testing ended within an hour. Notes: junior researcher, in light of this interaction, has been removed from SCP-137 testing and officially reprimanded regarding using SCP objects to try to indulge his personal interests. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-136, Naked Doll, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.